So in this video, let's talk about the quality of fats on a ketogenic diet, okay? So typically on a ketogenic diet, we want between 65 to 75% of the total calories being fat. But we need to talk about the quality of fats because an average American consumes a ratio of omega-3 to omega-6, 1 to 16, very heavy on the omega-6, very low on the omega-3. Now, as far as the ratios go, some people say you need a 1-to-1 ratio, 1-to-2 ratio, 1-to-3. Here's my thought on that. It is true that if you're really heavy on the omega-6, you're gonna have more inflammatory conditions, but it's very, very time consuming and probably frustrating if you have to do these calculations all day long to try to figure out your ratios. A much better way to do this is to beef up, no pun intended, your omega-3 fatty acids and not necessarily worry too much about these fats, except make sure you avoid the GMO, the soy, the cottonseed, the corn oil, the canola oil. You definitely want to avoid these. Now, regarding the fats in seeds and nuts, yes, most of them are very heavy on the six, but there's other benefits, other nutrients in seeds and nuts that we're going to talk about. So a lot of the seeds and nuts will have vitamin E, they'll have B vitamins, they have minerals, there's phytonutrients. But as far as the ratios of omega-3 to omega-6, you can see that most of the nuts are heavy on the sixes and low on the threes. Now, when we get into the omega-3 fatty acids, okay, we're dealing with a kind of a pre-omega-6 fatty acid. We're not talking about like the active form, like EPA and DHA. It's kind of like a precursor to these. So ALA, alpha-linolenic acid, converts to DHA, but really at 5% if you're lucky. So it's not too much. So as we go down the list, you'll see almonds, 1 ounce, 0.002, then omega-6, 3.4. So you can see it's a lot heavier on the six, actually a lot heavier if you do the math. Cashews, 0.017 to 2.2, heavy on the omega-6. Chia, 4.9 omega-3 fatty acids to 1.6. So this is a lot heavier on omega-3. Same thing with flax, 6.4 to 1.7. Pecans, 0.28 to 5.8. Pistachios, you can see it's low to higher. Pumpkin, same thing. Sunflower, same thing. Okay, walnuts, we got 2.5 to 10. So even though the ratios are heavier on the six, walnut has the highest omega-3 of any of the nuts. Then we get peanuts, which is trace, high on the omega-6 fatty acids. Olives, you know, same deal, low three, high six. Okay, so now let's go over to the seafood, okay, section right here. You're gonna get most of your omega-3 fatty acids from seafood. That is the best source. And I'm gonna recommend to at least get 1 gram to possibly 2 grams of omega-3 fatty acids per day. Now, I should also add EPA to this right here because we want collectively both of these to total 1 to 2 grams per day, ideally. Because if we focus on the omega-3 fatty acids, you don't really have to worry too much about the omega-6 as long as you're not doing these down here, okay? All right, so now let's go into the specifics. Okay, salmon, EPA, 0.62, okay, grams. DHA, 1.1 gram, that's 3 ounces of salmon. So this is pretty high. So salmon has high amounts of DHA. So salmon would be very, very good on the ketogenic diet. One thing I realized that I don't have on here is salmon oil. One of the problems with salmon oil is that most of the time it's farm raised, okay? So you never want to consume salmon oil if it's farm raised. You want to do the wild caught. But salmon oil has even more DHA than the cod liver oil. But salmon itself has good amounts. Okay, crab, 0.26, and then 0.11 DHA. And it has some, not terribly large amounts, but it has some. Canned tuna, 0.08 to 0.24. Anchovy, 0.6 to 0.9. So anchovies are pretty high in DHA. Mackerel, 0.6 to 0.9. Again, mackerel is a really good source. Salmon, pink can, 0.9, 0.8. This is a really good source as well. Sardines, 0.5 and 0.5. Not bad. Not bad at all. Of course, you know, always get wild caught. Collard oil, one of my favorites, 0.6 to 0.5. The thing about collard oil is it's high in vitamin D and high in vitamin A. Okay, then we get krill oil as 0.3 and then 0.3. The one challenge that I have with krill oil is that sometimes they use solvents to extract the oil. So make sure that if you're going to buy a krill oil, make sure they don't do that. You know, get some data, find out that you're not doing the one with the solvents. Okay, eggs have 0.1 DHA. It has something, but sometimes they'll spike the egg by giving the chicken some flaxseed, and you'll have more DHA, but the problem is it's still commercial eggs, so you want an egg that is pasture-raised, organic. It's worth the extra cost. The other thing about fish oils in general, never do a cheap fish oil. They're rancid. Okay, they use solvents. Go high quality. I think the best thing would be a wild-caught salmon oil or a virgin cod liver oil. Those are the two that I would recommend. But to boost the quality of fats on the keto, focus on increasing more omega-3 fatty acids and stick with these right here. Walnuts would be good, chia seed, maybe some flax. All right, thanks for watching. Hey, if you're liking this content, please subscribe now, and I will actually keep you updated on future videos.